Hello and welcome to WCBN Sports' coverage of Michigan basketball. I'm Alex Drain, joined today by Ryan Buckman here for Michigan's season opener against the Bowling Green Falcons. A long, long off season after the previous season was cut short in the Big Ten tournament, and then normally the season would have started about 3 weeks ago, so a long, long layoff, but certainly excited to get this one going.
Yeah, definitely. I think today's game is going to be definitely a testament of, well, at least somewhat of a soft picture of what's going to happen this year for Michigan. They have a couple of big key transfers coming in, Shaun D. Brown and Mike Smith, who are going to be definitely players to watch at the start of the season.
Yeah, for sure, as well as a really good freshman class that Michigan brought in, ranked number one in the Big Ten in the recruiting rankings. Hunter Dickinson, the centerpiece of that. He's not in the starting lineup, but we imagine we'll see a lot of him going through the starting lineups. Michigan will be starting Mike Smith, who you mentioned, at point guard, filling in, of course, for Xavier Simpson, who graduated. Eli Brooks at shooting guard, and then Franz Wagner at small forward. Up front, Isaiah Livers at power forward, and Austin Davis at center for Bowling Green. They will be starting Caleb Fields and Caden Metheny in the backcourt. Justin Turner, the star guard for Bowling Green. And then up front, Dylan Swingle at center and Daquan Plowden at power forward for these two teams. Michigan last year finished with a 19-12 record. Bowling Green finished with a 21-10 record. Bowling Green was number two in the MAC. We're going to try to play their way into the tournament. They have not made the tournament in 52 years. So a lot on the line for Bowling Green this season. They get their star Justin Turner back. They've got a lot to be excited about.
Yeah, I think they do. I think they got some really key players on that team that will definitely contend for winning the conference this year. Early in the season, it's going to be interesting to say the least, considering many factors that are going to go into this weird year for basketball so far, but I look forward to this being a pretty tight game early on. We'll see if Michigan can be able to pull away there, because it's going to be a little bit of a contest and just people getting their feet wet.
Yeah, that's going to be something to watch for sure. Michigan plays five non-conference games before the Big Ten gets started. We apologize if it's a little loud in the background at the moment. They're doing the starting lineup announcements, but Michigan plays Bowling Green today, then they'll have Oakland in here over the weekend, and then Ball State, UCF, and then NC State in the Big Ten ACC Challenge before they dive right in to the Big Ten slate. So it's a small little trial run of non-conference teams, but credit Michigan for scheduling a team like Bowling Green, who is pretty solid and is towards the top of their mid-major conference.
Yeah, Bowling Green is definitely a team that not only is going to contend for the MAC, but I think has a really good shot at also making the tournament as well.
Yep.
As the top team in the conference, of course. But I think what we're looking forward to for Michigan as well is going to be, like you said, those freshmen, are they going to be able to contend early on here in the year and for at least some starting time, or at least some playing time, that is. We'll definitely have to see.
And there's just a lot of new pieces for Michigan here on the roster. You lose John Teske, a two-year starter. Xavier Simpson, a three-year starter. And Simpson especially played with the ball in his hands so much. That alone is going to bring new challenges, not to mention two new transfers, a bunch of freshmen. And then, you know, questions about guys like Austin Davis up front, perhaps. Brandon Johns as well, who have played some over the last couple seasons but are looking to take larger roles this year. And I think really the rotation is the big question. What are the lineups going to look like? What pieces fit together? And that's going to be the interesting question for Juwan Howard and his coaching staff.
Yeah, and one thing I'm going to definitely look at to start this year is definitely if they can be able to get more rebounds and if they can be a little bit cleaner with the ball. I know they had that was an issue a year ago. It's one thing that if they clean up, I think they're going to be very, very good and a tough contender in the Big Ten this year. And especially if they are able to win some key games early on to kind of build a little bit of momentum and some confidence.
Yeah. Both teams have now finished their lineup announcements. They put their starters on the floor, and we're just seconds away from tip-off. Michigan wearing the home whites, Bowling Green in the orange uniforms. Of course, no fans here with the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic. We hope you are all safe and healthy at home and getting ready for the Thanksgiving holiday here. As we're just about to tip off, it'll be Dylan Swingle and Austin Davis tipping it up, and the much larger Davis does win the tip-off. And just like that, we have an immediate whistle. Don't think the clock started.
That just is the epitome of what this year has been so far.
The referees now walk over to the scorer's table, and we have fake crowd noise being piped into Crisler right now. A lot of screaming in the background, even though there's nothing going on the court. Now the referees are walking away from the scorer's table. They've adjusted the clock. Now it's running, even though the ball hasn't been inbounded. They'll throw it in. Wagner will do the inbound. There's a lot of extra space around the court this year. The courtside seats that were normally there are not there, so a lot of extra room if players go out of bounds. They won't be running into fans sitting in the front row. Now the clock is just running nonstop, and they can't stop it. It's down to 19:31. Almost 30 seconds have ticked off with no game action now happening since they started it. Now referee walks back over. They stopped it at 19:29. We'll see if they can put 20 more seconds back on the clock.
It's definitely a great way to start the year.
Yeah, very fitting beginning. We've got one referee standing at midcourt looking at the scorer's table and waiting for them to get it right. Now the clock reads 27:29.
As you said, with them taking away the front stands this year, I think that's going to make some of these players a lot more aggressive, trying to keep the ball in play.
Yeah, very well could be. Here we go. Wagner inbounds the ball to Mike Smith. The clock is properly running. Smith, the senior transfer from Columbia, gets it to Eli Brooks in the elbow. He dribbles out towards the three-point arc. Now he waits to find Wagner coming off the screen. Wagner inside, steps around, little baby hook off the mark, but Austin Davis gets the rebound, couple steps, tries to go up for it, and he'll draw a foul on Swingle.
And I believe Austin Davis, I know last year he had a little struggling time at the free throw stripe, but
yeah,
he definitely couldn't be able to put those type of woes behind him by making a couple here.
54%, as you mentioned, a year ago from the free throw line. And now the crowd noise is still going, even though a Michigan player is at the free throw line, making it sound very hostile. He puts the first one through, and the first points of the Michigan college basketball season are on the board. 1-0 Wolverines. Here comes the second free throw. Davis still wearing that black sleeve on his right arm. His second one is good. Those are two good-looking free throws, and Michigan takes a 2-0 lead. Falcons inbound it. Coming up the floor with it right there is Caleb Fields. They'll quickly pass it around. Daquan Plowden, then they get it down low to Swingle. Guarded by Davis. Low post, spins around, tries to put up a hook shot off the mark, tipped around, and it goes out of bounds off Michigan. Wagner tried to save it, but the shot from Swingle did not hit rim, so the shot clock is now down to 12 seconds. And Caleb Fields will go to inbound it from the baseline, gets it into the big man Swingle. Then outside is Justin Turner. Turner runs into trouble. 5 seconds now on the shot clock. Dribbling baseline underneath. That shot didn't hit rim, but Michigan grabs it anyway. Wagner, good defense. Livers picks it up. He's going to run in transition. Brings it up the floor. Falcons do well to get back. Livers at the free throw line. Now kicks it out to Eli Brooks. Brooks baseline. Kicks to Wagner in the corner. Around to Smith. They got Livers open for three. And that one off the heel. Tipped around. Now outside, Brooks' offensive rebound. His three-pointer off the mark. Livers tips that one around. Michigan crashing the offensive glass hard, but the Falcons able to snag it. Fields comes up the floor. Fields gets a small screen, gets in the lane, then kicks it out to Plowden. Now across to Justin Turner, the favorite to win MAC Player of the Year. He drives inside left-handed. Layup off the glass and good. And it's 2-2, 18:25 to go in the first half. And now we're going to get a moving screen on Austin Davis as Wagner was coming around the corner there. It'll be the first foul on Michigan.
Yeah, definitely right now. I can definitely see Michigan just trying to test the waters and be able to see what they can and can't do early on here.
Now the Falcons inbounded in. Metheny at half court, guarded by Smith. Drives inside the three-point arc. Tough fall-away jumper. No good. Michigan grabs the rebound. Here comes Brooks up the floor. He swings it over to Wagner on the wing. Open for three. That one a little short. Michigan's three-pointer's not falling early. They start 0 for 3 from the three-point line. Falcons come up the floor. Get a little screen. Long three-point attempt is off the mark. Wagner goes up. Can't grab the rebound. And now we're going to get a foul underneath, I believe, on Franz Wagner when he went up for the rebound. Or no, it's going to be on Bowling Green. It'll be on Swingle. That's now his second foul. And so Bowling Green may have to make a quick substitution here, and they will. The portly center goes off the floor, and they're going to bring in number 4.
That's trying
to say exactly who, what number was that that came on the floor. We'll get that in just a second. Michigan comes up the floor with it. Appears to be number 0, Jacob Washington, subbing in at center. He's a little smaller at 6'8", transfer. Now they get it outside to Smith. He'll drive inside the arc, draws a foul. It's now the third foul on Bowling Green.
Bowling Green's defense has come out pretty strong right now, definitely getting their hands in the lane, creating some tough passing situations for Michigan.
Perhaps a little too in the lane there, just committing a small reach-in foul. Now Michigan will inbound the ball from left wing side. Eli Brooks will do the inbounding nods. Michigan has not made a substitution yet in this game. Smith comes out and gets the inbound pass. Passes it over to Wagner, back to Smith. He dribbles into the corner, now fires way across the court. Livers open for three from the wing. That one is through. And Michigan finally puts through a three, and they lead 5-2, 17-20 to go in the first half.
Isaiah Livers still a big impact for this team. It's shown so far.
Three-point marksman spacing the floor right there, and a nice assist from Mike Smith. Bowling Green Falcons with the basketball. Dribbling around just inside the arc. Now backing off. Pass across to Metheny. Metheny guarded by the much larger Wagner. Now 10 on the shot clock. We'll see if he tries to drive him. Now he lost his dribble. It's loose on the floor. Eli Brooks has it. Flips it over to Wagner. He's loose down the floor. And he'll dunk it through. A two-handed slam. And Michigan leads 7-2.
Great job by Eli Brooks. Just really getting handsy right there and making it difficult for Bowling Green.
Yeah, Metheny was trying to drive around Wagner, lost his dribble. Brooks gets in there, pries the ball free. Michigan gets a transition bucket. Now Metheny with it outside. He'll dribble around the arc, gets a screen from Plowden, flips it over to him, Daquan Plowden. Now down to Washington at the elbow. His baby jumper is off the mark. Livers grabs the rebound down, and he'll run up the floor with it. Crossover to Wagner, back to Livers, back to Wagner. They pass around with it, these Michigan wings outside. 18 on the shot clock, 16-11 to go in the first half. 7-2 Wolverines. Livers dribbles between two men, kicks it out. Smith from the corner, that one's good. 4-3, and Michigan leads now 10-2. Mike Smith makes his first basket in a Michigan uniform. Now the Falcons with the ball. Plowden with it just inside the three-point arc. Hands it off to Metheny. Smith playing really tight defense. Now he'll get around Smith to the rack. Lays it up. Count it. And a foul.
Wow. That was a very aggressive move there by Metheny.
He got a little bit of space around Mike Smith. Drove to the hoop. Finished. And drew contact. We'll go to the under 16 timeout. Michigan leading 10-4. Michigan has made their last three field goals, shooting 43% from the field, 2 of 5 now from three. What are your early impressions of this team so far?
For Bowling Green, they are definitely trying to set up a lot of screens right now. I think that's their best option right now, considering they have a slight height disadvantage for Michigan. And if you get some of that space open, definitely create some more open shots for you. So far, it's done pretty well. I mean, but Michigan right now is doing what I think they couldn't do as strong, or at moments they did strong last year, but other times didn't, was shoot the three. And right now, I believe they're 2 for 5, I believe?
Yep, 40%. Michigan last year was a 34% shooting team from three, but a big question, obviously, is Franz Wagner. He shot only 31% from three last year, but he was a much better shooter in Germany, and he broke his hand before the season. A lot of questions about whether that affected his shooting stroke. And obviously bringing Mike Smith in, who's a pretty good shooter compared to Xavier Simpson, who of course was never much of a shooter at Michigan. A lot of reason to think this team could be a better three-point shooting team than last year.
Yeah, they definitely did a good job at trying to get some transfers and some freshmen in here that can definitely step back from the long range to hit it. And especially from the corner, I think that's the definite spot. Last year, I believe Michigan many times couldn't try to hit was from the corner. So if you get some guys out there from the corner that can be able to hit it, I think that's going to be a huge advantage.
10-4 Michigan leads if you're just joining us on WCBN Sports' coverage of Michigan basketball. We'll have every home game that they play this season covered here on our YouTube channel. Obviously, we don't know how many home games. There will be a lot of uncertainty in the college basketball world, a number of games being canceled today or postponed. But Michigan playing, both these teams passed their COVID tests and are ready to play here today. Wolverines will have Oakland in over the weekend. We'll have that one covered as well. And Oakland played today against Xavier. So the assumption at the moment is that Oakland should be ready to play this weekend. So far, so good for Michigan basketball's early season campaign. Both teams in their huddles right now. We'll see if Michigan makes any substitutions out of the timeout. We've seen only the starting rotation so far, but obviously Hunter Dickinson, Brandon Johns, Sean D. Brown, all candidates to come in at later points in this game. And obviously, if the Michigan Wolverines are able to seize a big lead, we may see more of the reserves, including freshmen Zeb Jackson, Jace Howard, and Terrence Williams II.
Definitely, I'm going to be excited to see what Hunter Dickinson is able to put on the floor here. He's definitely one of those sought-after recruits that definitely is one of the best prospects in the nation right now.
Yeah. Doesn't come out of this timeout. Michigan's going to stick with their starting five on the floor. Bowling Green breaks their huddle and walk down to the Michigan end. Remember that Metheny will have a free throw upcoming after he made the and-one basket before the timeout. The foul was on Smith. Michigan so far has committed two fouls, Bowling Green with three. And that one is right through. Metheny threads it. And now Michigan inbounds the ball. Bowling Green playing more of a half-court press at this point. Brooks delivers tight man defense at the moment. Smith dribbles around the big block Emmett center. Now over to Livers, to Brooks. Wagner, right wing side. Now Livers at the elbow, backing in. He's into the lane. Now turnaround, fadeaway jumper. That one just off the heel. And no good. Rebound snatched down by Davin Ziegler. And they come up the floor.
I believe someone lost a shoe on the other end.
Fields to Metheny. Around to Plowden. Now outside, back to Fields, back to Plowden. He's from three. That one is way off the mark. Wagner grabs down the rebound. Michigan running up in transition. Wagner going to try to get in the lane to the rack. Lays it up and lays it in. 12-5. Michigan extends their lead, rather. 14:42 to go here in the first half. Now it looks like Sean D. Brown and Hunter Dickinson are sitting ready to come in at the next whistle. Bowling Green into the lane. That's Justin Turner. His shot a little short. Franz Wagner the rebound. Mike Smith running in transition up to Brooks. They've got a man open in the corner. That's Livers. His three is off the mark. Livers cold to begin the game so far. Now the Falcons run up the other direction. They like to play an up-tempo style of basketball. Metheny with the rock. Dribbles to his left. Now across Plowden. His three, and that one is through. 12-8, Michigan.
I believe that was Eli Brooks who lost his shoe. Been playing out there a while now with one shoe on.
Yeah, it's like his left shoe. Livers from three, that one in and out. Davis tips it around, can't grab the rebound. Now Livers continues to struggle, 1-for-5 now from the floor. Metheny around Smith to the hoop, and pretty good defense from Smith, forces a miss, didn't get any rim. Wagner the rebound, they run around with it. Brooks outside, pump fake, but I think he stepped out of bounds on the pump fake. And now Michigan will bring their substitutions in, as will Bowling Green. 13:40 to go in the first half, 12-8 Wolverines. So Hunter Dickinson checking in for the first time in his collegiate career, 7'1", 255 pounds from Alexandria, Virginia, played in Maryland at Dematha Catholic, one of the most famous programs in the country, highly sought after recruit that Michigan beat Duke for, among other schools. And he'll anchor the center position. Also into the game, Sean D. Brown, 6'5", 215, grad transfer, senior from Wake Forest, one of the better players in the ACC the last couple of seasons. He checks in for Michigan wearing number 15. Dickinson wearing the big number one in the middle. Livers, Wagner stay out there, as does, I believe, Mike Smith, but he's bending her over. No, that's Eli Brooks trying to put the shoe back on.
Yeah, Hunter Dickinson definitely looks looks pretty big out there compared to a lot of the players, so we'll see if that helps him.
Yeah, he's a big, big boy. And so here come the Falcons. Ziegler with the ball. Now passes it across to Trey Diggs. He hands it off to Justin Turner. Step back, decided not to shoot. Plowden goes around Brooks to the rack. No, rebound is put back in. Offensive board there from Washington. And now it's 12-10, Michigan on top. Falcons playing it close early on. Again, this is a pretty good MAC team. We're number two in their conference last season. Brooks drives inside, kicks it out. Sean D. Brown from the corner. His three is off the mark. Michigan continues to shoot a lot of threes, but 2-for-7 at the moment from distance. Falcons grab the rebound, and the men in orange come up the floor. Justin Turner, crossover on Wagner. Drives inside, throws on the brakes, kicks it out to Ziegler. Ziegler tries to go around Brown. Now drives baseline. His shot is blocked by Brown. Tipped out of bounds off of the shooter, Diggs. And it'll be Michigan basketball. You see the length there of Sean D. Brown to snuff out that fadeaway jumper.
Yeah, he's a very good defensive player for sure, and definitely that is something Michigan last year at moments did very well, but other times did not do so well.
Yeah, Michigan's defense definitely took a slide without Luke Jaklich last year. At a nice defensive play from Sean D. Brown there. Dickinson comes out to set a screen. Brooks doesn't want it. Drives inside. His little running hook is off the mark. Now the Bowling Green with the rebound. Diggs brings it up the floor. Now over to Ziegler. Michigan pretty cold from the field right now. Driving inside. There's a swat by Dickinson. But the rebound goes right to a player in orange. Now that pass is intercepted by Franz Wagner. The length of Michigan showing out right now. Brooks drives up the floor. They pass it around. Livers from the corner. That three is good. And Michigan leads 15-10.
Yeah, you just can't leave Livers open for any moment. I think when he gets his feet set, he's pretty deadly.
Assist to Franz Wagner there. Now the Falcons come up the floor. Sean D. Brown playing tight defense. Passes over to Trey Diggs. Livers right on him. Diggs gets a small screen, drives into the lane, throws on the brakes, kicks it out. Now cutting inside, pass to Washington is intercepted. Wagner picks it up to Sean D. Brown. He drives inside, puts it up, and it's going to be an offensive foul. Drawing the charge in the lane was Trey Diggs there. That'll be Brown's first foul. Michigan turns it over. And we head to the under 12 media timeout. Our score, Michigan 15, Bowling Green 10, 11:39 to go in the first half. You're listening to Michigan basketball on WCBN Sports. Well, Michigan, the early 5-point lead. They're shooting 36% from the field. Bowling Green 27%. 3-point range pretty even. Rebounds pretty even as well. Michigan just a little cold. They're trying a lot of threes. Bowling Green's giving them the space. They're not knocking down a high percentage at the moment, but this is about what we expected so far. Bowling Green playing it competitive. Neither team running away yet, but definitely an entertaining game.
Oh yeah, definitely entertaining game. It's kind of what you want to see early on here in the year, is try to find a lot of entertainment out of the games, especially when you don't know what to expect so far. I think right now both teams are playing very aggressive, and Bowling Green has definitely come prepared for sure. They are definitely getting on the rebounds, trying to create more opportunities for them on the offensive boards, and Michigan as well, trying to create some opportunities as well with a couple of turnovers right now as well.
Just saw on the Jumbotron a sort of little game type graphic with Michigan's freshman class, it was Jace Howard and Zeb Jackson doing one set, and then Terrence Williams and Hunter Dickinson asking each other questions. And, you know, this Michigan recruiting class, number one in the Big Ten, and recruiting is something Juwan Howard's done very well since coming to Michigan. He's got the number one recruiting class in the country, let alone the Big Ten, signed for next year. That may change as more recruits commit, but he's done very well on the trail. And what's interesting about this Michigan roster is it's kind of a mix of old and very young. There's not a lot in the middle, but they've got a lot of good seniors. Livers, Austin Davis, Mike Smith, Eli Brooks, and Shaundy Brown. And then they've got a good freshman class, and there's not as much in the middle. Franz Wagner and Brandon John's the exception to that, but it'll be interesting to see how they're able to mesh the youth and the freshmen with the extensive experience that guys like Livers have.
Yeah, I definitely think some of the veterans can definitely see what happened last year and be able to take that experience and teach a freshman a lot of the ways that Juwan Howard wants to really have his team play, and especially try to fix some things that were an issue last year.
Yeah.
And they are playing, I think, as aggressive as I thought they were early on. It's just the shots haven't been falling.
And I think it's also really a boon for a guy like Howard to come in and start building a program and have a guy like Livers as a holdover from the Beeline era. Livers, you know, played in the Final Four as a freshman, and even last year with Teske and Simpson having played in the Final Four as well. Those guys helped set the culture and the tone for the program that Howard's trying to build, and help teach the young freshmen, you know, what it takes to make it to the Final Four and make the, you know, win the Big Ten tournament and so on. Back out of the media timeout. Bowling Green inbounds it after that offensive foul on Brown. Siegler comes up the court. Mike Smith back into the game. Brandon Johns has subbed in. He's playing the power forward position. Dickinson's still out there. Falcons pass it around. Trey Diggs back across. Siegler gets a screen. Now he's going to try to dribble inside. Pass outside. Diggs gets Wagner to go up. Now he holds it back. Throws it back outside. 4 seconds. Three on the shot clock. Siegler has to put it up, and he knocks it through. A heave at the shot clock expiration. And Bowling Green pulls back within two, 15-13. Mike Smith brings the ball up. 11 minutes to go in the first half. Hunter Dickinson comes out to set the screen. Now flips it around. Wagner inside Dickinson. Two men on him. And a bump underneath, I think, on Jacob Washington is called.
Yeah, Bowling Green has definitely taken majority shots, but I think from beyond the arc, they've been able to take advantage of the couple that they've been able to make so far compared to Michigan.
Smith kicks it out to Johns in the corner. Now he dribbles inside at the elbow, draws a double team. He's got Hunter Dickinson there. The big man puts up the three. That one just off the heel. Nobody underneath the basket to rebound it. And now Bowling Green picks it up. They dribble up the court, driving inside, trying to go around Smith. Kick to the centerman, Washington, and it just went right off his body and out of bounds. Michigan takes over on the turnover.
Yeah, I think Howard early on wants his guys to get back and play defense just so they don't give up easy buckets. And
look at this from Mike Smith, way up the floor as fast as he could, and there was a block underneath. I guess they're going to call a foul. That looked pretty clean to me, but they're going to hit, I believe, Washington underneath on Bowling Green for a foul.
Gotta like how aggressive Mike Smith got right there. That came out of nowhere, kind of shocked everyone.
Yeah, just came sprinting up the floor and caught Bowling Green flat-footed, draws a foul, so he'll go to the free throw line. First free throw is no good. He's an 81% free throw shooter, so pretty uncharacteristic there from Smith. Now Wagner comes off the floor, Livers comes back on. So the current lineup for Michigan is Smith, Brown, Livers, Johns, and Dickinson. A very tall lineup right now outside of Smith, who stands at 5'11", but everybody else 6'5 and above, and then Dickinson, of course, at 7'1 at center. Smith's second is through, so Michigan takes a 16-13 lead, 10:26 to go in the first half. Trey Diggs comes up the floor with it, hands it off to Siegler. Back to Diggs, they get it over to Caleb Young. Now to Plowden. Open shooter from three. That one rims around and off. Livers grabs the rebound, and over the back foul on Bowling Green is going to be called.
Bowling Green foul was to 10, Cam Young. His second personal. Team six.
Foul is on Young.
I think as we get on earlier in this, or get up later into this game, we're going to see more fouls called with everyone getting a little bit tired, I think, especially for Bowling Green if they Michigan ends up getting a bigger lead.
Michigan inbounds the ball. We're at the halfway mark of the first half and the quarter mark of the contest. Shaundi Brown goes inside to Dickinson. He's got a huge height advantage. Great pass to Livers on the wing. That three is good. We read a lot about Hunter Dickinson's passing ability from the post as a center, and you saw it right there.
That was very great passing. That was some of the best passing I've seen so far in possession today.
Bowling Green comes up the floor at the big block M. Ziegler passes it across. There's Cam Young dribbling inside, and he'll draw a foul on Dickinson underneath.
Yeah, I think Dickinson right there just got to learn to keep his feet on the floor right there and just use that size advantage to his benefit.
It'll be Turner actually at the free throw line. Justin Turner. Rather, that's not Justin Turner, that's Chandler Turner, my apologies. Justin Turner also on the floor. Two different Turners in the lineup right now. The interesting thing about them are that they both from Detroit Renaissance High School. That second one off the mark. Rebound down by Mike Smith. Smith pass tipped by Livers. Smith gets it back, gets a screen, dribbles inside, and he'll be tripped up driving to the basket.
So now, Bowling Green might be getting a little too aggressive. Now I believe that's like the third or fourth foul within the past minute.
Yeah, foul starting to pile up, and Michigan now into the bonus. It'll be a 1-1 for Smith. Smith stands at the free throw line. Dribbles the basketball three times, bends the knees and delivers. That one is through. Now 2 for 3 on the day. Again, an 81% free throw shooter during his season last year at Columbia, where he was first team all Ivy League, playing for a very bad Columbia team, carried a lot of weight. We'll get to play with more talented pieces here at Michigan. He makes the second free throw. And now Michigan leads 21-14. 9:19 to go in the first half. Michigan playing aggressive defense right now. Shaundi Brown follows Justin Turner up the floor. Now quick double team. Now across to Plowden. His three-pointer is off the mark. A little bit wide right. Took an odd bounce into the hands of Brandon Johns for the rebound. Now Mike Smith flips it to Brandon Johns. Drives baseline, lays it up, and uses the glass to put it in. 23-14, largest lead of the game for Michigan.
This is Brandon Johns Jr.'s first points of the year.
Yep. 23-14, Wolverines. Michigan lost a man outside. That's Turner. His three-pointer, no good. Chandler Turner. A little strong on that attempt. Now they flip it inside. Smith to Dickinson. Triple teamed. Puts it off the high glass and puts it in. And Bowling Green's going to have to take a timeout as Michigan on a bit of a run right now. I believe that's a 9-0 run to lead 25-14. Or a 6-0 run over the last minute officially. But a larger lead beyond that as well.
Yeah, that's definitely how Michigan wants to use Hunter Dickinson. Was definitely inside the basket, inside the arc there, down low, and able to just feed him the ball. That would be the perfect scenario for Michigan this year.
Well, and this was a game where you really wanted to see, you know, Michigan use their big men and use their height advantage, especially Hunter Dickinson, in that Dickinson standing at 7-1, and you look around Bowling Green's roster, Swingle at 6'10", outside of that, not a lot of tall guys, as is usually the case on mid-major teams, and so Dickinson able to use his height there, guarded by three players, and just lays it up and lays it in. 8:28 to go in the first half. Michigan's made their last three from the floor. Quick points check as we look at the box. Livers leads Michigan with 9 points, Mike Smith with 6, Faulkner with 4, and then 3 players with 2, Dickinson, Johns, and Austin Davis. Brown and Brooks have played but have not scored yet. And for Bowling Green, pretty egalitarian right now. Ziegler with 3, Plowden with 3, and Metheny with 3. Turner with 2, Washington with 2, and Chandler Turner with 1, 25-14 Michigan leads.
Yeah, Michigan's height advantage is definitely showing up on the stat sheet as well. 3 blocks already for them, and compared to none for Bowling Green so far. So it definitely, there is a bigger height advantage for Michigan.
Well, we look at Bowling Green as Michael Huger takes the timeout there. In his 5th season at Bowling Green, has built a pretty good program. Again, they've not made the tournament since 1968, but given their tough baseline, he's cobbled together back-to-back 20-plus win seasons. Was at 21-10 last year, second in the MAC, and you know, returning a lot of pieces, including the projected MAC Player of the Year in Justin Turner. They could make a run to win the conference and finally break that tournament drought. He's at 88-75 in his 5th season since being hired as Bowling Green head coach. Meanwhile, Juwan Howard at 19-12 last year, beginning his 2nd season with Michigan. A couple young coaches building their respective programs.
Yeah, and it was just too bad we couldn't see a tournament last year. We never know what might have actually happened and who might have been able to get in.
Yeah.
Especially with some of the conference tournaments not finishing either.
Yeah. Michigan was in the 8-9 matchup with Rutgers in the Big Ten tournament when that was called off. It was just moments before they were about to play Rutgers, as a matter of fact. They were the first game of the day on that Thursday, day 2 of the Big Ten tournament. So Bowling Green called the timeout. They have the basketball, trying to stop this Michigan run, 6-0 over the last 53 seconds. Bowling Green has not made a field goal in almost 3 minutes, shooting 26% from the floor, 5 of 19. Inbound pass to Caden Metheny. He's back onto the floor. Gets a screen from Plowden. Now another one. Dribbles around. Flips it to Plowden outside. He's matched up with Hunter Dickinson. Shaundi Brown doing a great job to deny a passing lane. He finally gives it off. Here's Justin Turner into the lane. His shot too high. But the tip-in is good and a foul as well. Nice play there to get that tip-in underneath by, looks like, Daquan Plowden. And they're going to hit Shaundi Brown with the foul. His 2nd foul, team 5th. And Plowden will get his and one free throw right here. Plowden an odd shooting motion, and his free throw rattles around and down, 85% from the line last year. Now, Bowling Green going to play aggressive defense on the inbound. They get it into Smith. Here comes the trap. He flips it over, delivers. Now into Dickinson in the middle. Pass across to Shaundi Brown. The pass was a little behind him. Brown almost lost it out of bounds. Now he gets it back. Livers in the corner. Flips it up to Dickinson. Baseline. He's going to go up with it. First try now. Second attempt. It goes through. 27-17. Michigan on top.
Definitely trying to get some more baskets on the inside for Michigan.
Metheny comes up the floor. Dribbles around Mike Smith. They kick it out. Plowden. Dickinson gives him the room. And he knocks it down. Daquan Plowden. Shooting very, very well right now.
Yes.
For Bowling Green, 3 of 6 from the field, 2 of 4 from 3. It's 27-20. Smith dribbles inside, kicks baseline. Shaundi Brown goes up for the jam, and he's knocked off the ball. A foul is called.
Michigan making a couple of nice moves there into the basket, creating some good opportunities for them to get some more points.
Team 8th foul there. The foul will go on Plowden. And Brown will go to the free throw line to shoot 2. He's an 83% free throw shooter last year at Wake Forest, and he swishes the first. 28-20, Michigan on top. Michigan will make a substitution. Franz Wagner checks in for Hunter Dickinson. So Dickinson and Davis both off the court. Michigan's going to go with the small ball lineup. Brown misses the 2nd free throw. Ziegler snatches down the rebound. 28-20, Michigan on top. Metheny cross to Ziegler, dribbles around with it. Now outside, Plowden. Going to try to dribble inside around Sean D. Brown. His layup just no good. Wagner grabs the rebound in transition. Here comes Livers, drives inside. They're going to say it was knocked out of bounds off Bowling Green. Don't know about that.
Yeah.
It looked like Livers was just out of control. Michigan makes a substitution of Eli Brooks. They should be going to an under 8-minute commercial timeout, but I guess they're not going to. Anyway, Michigan will inbound it right in. Smith into Wagner. They kick it inside. Mike Smith in the lane. A fadeaway jumper is good. Michigan leads 30-20. A little good fortune there on the Livers ball out of bounds.
Mike Smith there kind of reminds me a little bit of Xavier Simpson, except he's been able to take some really solid fadeaway shots.
Yeah, Simpson probably would have hooked it there instead of the fadeaway jumper. Metheny dribbles baseline. He'll draw a bump, I think, on Brandon Johns. 6:37 to go in the first half, and it does go on Johns. First personal, team sixth. So Bowling Green, next foul will be into the bonus. Michigan leads 30-20. 6:37 to go in the first half. Passed around outside. It's like Turner, jab step, and his three-pointer hits nothing. This is where the air ball chance would come in if there were fans. Livers pass across. Mike Smith outside. Dribbles inside the lane. Now to Livers. Cuts in. Distribute across. Wagner open three. That one just no good. Johns underneath. We got a whistle, and it's going to be an offensive foul on Johns. Too vigorous in pursuing that rebound.
Yeah, it definitely seems early on that everything on the boards is getting called for fouls a lot. And I guess that doesn't really shock me. I guess when you're not used to playing for a while against another opponent, it can definitely have that effect.
And Michigan now has put Bowling Green into the bonus, and so free throws will be coming for Daquan Plowden. His 1-1 makes the first. Bowling Green now 4-for-5 at the free throw line in this game. Michigan 6-for-8. 8 team fouls on Bowling Green, 7 now on Michigan. Plowden's second rattles around and goes down. He's now 3-for-3 at the line, and he's got 11 points on the game, exactly half of his team's total. 30-22, Michigan on top. Brooks, Livers, Wagner outside. Johns in the post. He's got a height advantage. Starting to back down towards the rack, and he's going to draw a foul.
I do like how Bowling Green is able to still just be as aggressive as they were at the start of the game in the inside. They might be getting called for some more fouls right now, but there's other moments where they get some advantage of a missed shot on the inside.
Foul will go on Devin Ziegler, who is 6'3", was trying to guard the 6'8 Johns. He puts Johns at the line for 2 free throws. Johns was only 64% from the free throw line last year. He makes the first, 31-22. Michigan's offense clicking right now at 5 of their last 6 from the floor. Bowling Green, a pretty good offensive team last year, not as much defensive, and so we were expecting a bit of a high-scoring game. Michigan was also more of an offensive team. Johns makes them both. Those are good, 2 good-looking free throws. Getting some confidence. And he'll go right off. And here we go. Terrence Williams, the second, is checking in for Michigan. His first appearance in a Michigan uniform. The freshman from Clinton, Maryland, who played at Gonzaga College High School in Washington, D.C., Bowling Green passes around with it outside. Metheny over to Turner. Now trying to dribble inside, a shooter fadeaway. That is a good looking shot there from Fields. Caleb Fields evading the long reach of Isaiah Livers and a baseline fadeaway. It's 32-24. Livers hands it off to Williams. Now Wagner, Brooks. Drives inside, now kicks it out. Wagner in the lane. His lay-in, no. Second try, no. Tempted to tip it back in. Franz Wagner right now struggling with 4 points. Up comes Turner in the lane, lays it up, and lays it in. Count it. And a foul. And now Bowling Green has clawed back within 6, 32-26, and they'll have a free throw upcoming.
Yeah, those are two very impressive shots and moves right there by Bowling Green in the last two possessions.
And Justin Turner at the free throw line. And he makes the free throw, 32-27. Bowling Green, a quick little run here to claw their way back into the game. 5 minutes exactly remaining here in the first half. Terrence Williams with the ball. Off to Mike Smith. Smith dribbles inside to the rack, lays it up and lays it in. Muscular finish there from Mike Smith to shrug off the defenders. 34-27. Michigan now 6 of their last 8 from the field. They need to play better defense, though, here. Turner gets around Brooks, drives into the lane. His running hook, it is good off the glass. And right now you just see the talent of Justin Turner and Daquan Plowden starting to seep through for Bowling Green, even against a major conference defense. Bowling Green's made 3 of their last 3. They're 5 of their last 7 from the floor. Now we're going to get a kickball on Caleb Fields. Michigan will keep the ball. Shot clock reset to 20 seconds. 4:22 to go in the first half.
Michigan trying to stay out of foul trouble right there. They're giving Bowling Green a little bit more room than they'd like.
Wagner to Smith across to Isaiah Livers. 15 seconds on the shot clock. Really tight defense from Turner. Almost forces a turnover. Now he does. Metheny's loose. Down the floor. Lays it up and lays it in. Now it's a 3-point game. 34-31. You see the dribbling trouble of Isaiah Livers right there. Tight defense being played. And Bowling Green on a heck of a run right now to get back within one possession. Smith's going to draw a foul on Metheny, though. And we will head to the under 4 media timeout. 3:54 to go in the first half, but Bowling Green hanging around. Our score, Michigan 34, Bowling Green 31. Michigan's made 6 of their last 8 from the field. Bowling Green, 4 of their last 4. Michigan shooting almost 50% from the field. Bowling Green, 39%.
Yeah, some turnover woes right there for Michigan in the past about 3 or 4 minutes. I know earlier, about halfway through this first half, it was Michigan being able to get some good turnovers for them to turn into points, but in the opposite end now for Bowling Green is able to do that.
I want to thank all of you for joining us here on WCBN Sports' coverage of Michigan basketball against Bowling Green here the day before Thanksgiving. Michigan will be back at it over the weekend against Oakland. Current scoring leaders in this game, Mike Smith now is up to 10 to lead Michigan. Livers with 9 and 3 players with 4, Wagner, Dickinson, and Johns. Whereas for Bowling Green, Plowden at 11 and Turner at 7, really starting to assert themselves.
Yeah, definitely Smith as well. It looks like he's going to be one of those players this year that's probably going to have a big impact for this team, especially with his ball handling skills, being able to create some opportunities for other players on the floor.
34-31, Michigan on top. 3:54 to go here in the first half. Michigan had surged ahead to a hefty lead. I believe it was 26-15 at one, or 25-14 rather, at one point. But Bowling Green has been able to whittle it back in. That largest lead came at 8:30, remaining of the first half. And over the last 4.5 minutes, Bowling Green's worked their way back into it, mostly by looking really good from the floor, getting to the line, forcing turnovers, just putting a little pressure on the Michigan offense.
Yeah, you can definitely see Daquan Plowden starting to make a little bit more of an impact there on the floor. He is 3 for 7 from the field and has hit 3 triples as well and been able to get to the free throw line. So you can definitely tell his craftiness is definitely helping him get some more opportunities for his team.
Michigan women's basketball had their first game this afternoon. They were able to knock off Central Michigan University. Their next game is on Friday at Oakland University in Rochester. We're still waiting on the remainder of the schedule in the non-conference. Their Big Ten slate will start in December, December 19th, against Illinois. We'll try to have as many of the women's games as possible, the home ones covered. Also this weekend, Michigan hockey playing host to Notre Dame. We'll have both of those games on Friday and Saturday night over at Yost Ice Arena. Back to the game out of the timeout. Mike Smith stands at the free throw line. He'll be shooting two for Michigan. Smith's first free throw is right through. 35-31 Wolverines against the Falcons of Bowling Green here in Ann Arbor, Crisler Center. His second free throw, that one is good as well. 36-31 now, Michigan a 5-point lead. Devin Ziegler, who's played a lot of point guard in this game for Bowling Green, dribbles the ball up, hands it off to their star, Justin Turner. Now they'll go inside to the center. That shot, no. Tipped around. Livers saves it before he goes out of bounds. Gives it to Brooks. Now up the floor. Here comes Mike Smith. Kicks to the corner. Driving baseline. Terrence Williams throws it up. No. Rebound. Isaiah Livers for the putback. And it's 38-31 Michigan. Quick little 4-0 spurt out of the timeout.
Nice recognition by Livers there to get into the basket and get that rebound.
Turner to Plowden. Now across to Justin Turner, who I believe has played the entire game so far, as has Plowden. Hands it off to Ziegler. Smith gives him a little bit of room around the screen. Now he blows right by Smith to the rack. He had an easy layup, and he blew the bunny right there. Rebound grabbed down by Terrence Williams. Drives up the floor. Passes into the corner. Eli Brooks now back out. Wagner at half court. Smith, Livers, and Smith will retreat. Back out to the block M. Now 15 on the shot clock. 2:47 to go in the first half. Michigan by 7. Smith tries to get around Ziegler. Now he turns the corner inside, kicks it out. He's got Williams open for 3. That one a little strong. A good open look there for the freshman Terrence Williams, but put a little too much on it. The players in orange with the rock driving inside, laying it up and laying it in. A really nice athletic play there from Justin Turner to wiggle between two white shirts and put it in. And now Juwan Howard's going to call a quick timeout. 2:21 remaining in the first half. Michigan 38, Bowling Green 33.
Yeah, I don't think Juwan Howard was too happy with his defense here in the latter half here of the first half. I think they're creating a little bit more separation than they'd like over there on the defense end, and Bowling Green's been taking advantage of it.
Yeah, Bowling Green playing well at the moment, hanging with Michigan. 38-33. It's just a quick 30-second timeout. Howard trying to reset his defense. His offense is playing well, but the Falcons have made 5 of their last 7 from the floor, and in addition to having 7 free throw attempts, has helped to keep them in this game. Both teams have used a timeout now in the first half, the use it or lose it timeout. If no one uses another one, they'll both have 3 heading in to the halftime. Not sure how long halftime will be. I know in some of the sports they've had shorter halftimes. Hockey's had shorter intermissions between the periods to try and speed the games up. We'll see if that's the case here in the basketball season. Livers hands it off to Wagner. Gets a screen from Terrence Williams. Wagner drives inside. Oh, Bowling Green thought they had him tied up, but they're going to call a foul.
And that's just really good defense by Bowling Green.
Yeah.
I really thought that was a turnover, and I was wrong.
Yeah, and Bowling Green has the possession arrow. They would have taken the ball over there. It's perhaps the second favorable call that Michigan's gotten on that side of the offensive floor on the baseline. Wagner steps to the line. Michigan in the double bonus. He'll be shooting 2, but that first one rattles out. Franz, an 83% free throw shooter. Michigan now in this game, 10 of 13 from the free throw line. He'll get a second. The big German second attempt is good. 39-33, Michigan on top. 2:10 remaining in the first half. Now Justin Turner playing the point guard spot, guarded by Eli Brooks as he dribbles it up into the offensive half of the floor. Hands it off to Trey Diggs, who's back out there at the elbow. Gives it to Turner, who's switched on to Isaiah Livers. Now Turner's got some open space, a long two, and that one's a little short. Ball tipped around. It's loose. Bowling Green picks it up. Livers blocks it. Now it's still loose. Tipped around again. That one's going to roll out of bounds, they say, off Michigan.
Ooh.
But the referee might be overruling it. Trying to see. There's referees on the far side. No, it is going to stay with Bowling Green, I think.
Bowling Green basketball.
Yep. Michigan there was a miss, and it got tipped around into a spot where once I think Terrence Williams hit the floor, oh, maybe an injury over there. Looks like Franz Wagner might have rolled his ankle. And that's why Zeb Jackson is now subbed in, and now they have overruled it. All right, so that's what we thought initially.
Yeah.
Then the PA guy said Bowling Green ball. It'll be Michigan's ball. Now they say the call has been reversed, so Michigan will inbound it. And yeah, Wagner went right off onto the bench, and Zeb Jackson has checked in. Wagner is sitting over there and looks to be in some pain. The trainer is tending to his ankle. We see that on the Jumbotron right now. Regardless, Zeb Jackson, freshman from Maumee, Ohio, now out there. Good pass inside. Livers lays it up and in.
Wow.
That was, I think, Brandon Johns who whipped that one in there for Michigan. Now their lead back up to 8. 90 seconds remaining in the first half. Zeb Jackson standing at midcourt, guarding Davin Ziegler. 80 seconds to go. Ziegler is going to have a reach and foul called there on Brandon Johns. That will be his third, I believe.
Oh, boy.
Oh, no, they're going to give it to Zeb Jackson. That's a generous one. They say it's on the bump and not the reach in. Johns trying to get his hand in there as Ziegler was turning the corner. But Ziegler will go to the line. Single bonus for Bowling Green. So it's a 1-1. His first free throw is good. 41-34. Ziegler last year 78% from the free throw line. Bowling Green now 7 of 8 from the stripe today. His second one is also good. Bowling Green remains really strong on their free throws in this game. 8 of 9. Livers to inbound. Gets it into Brooks, who's playing essentially the point guard spot, even with Jackson out there. Livers pass over to Johns. It's Johns, Livers, Williams, Jackson, and Brooks right now for Michigan. 20 seconds on the shot clock, 105 in the game. Brooks dribbles around, kicks it out. Zeb Jackson for 3. That shot off the mark. Terrence Williams the rebound, lays it up, and there are the first points of Terrence Williams' Michigan career. Wolverines lead 43-35, 53 seconds to go in the half.
Yeah, 3 is just still not falling for Michigan right now. Trying to have to turn that around sometime.
Yeah, 4 of 13 now from beyond the arc, but good rebound there from Terrence Williams and the points. Now, tough contact there, trying to go around, trying to see the number. I think that was Justin Turner. Zeb Jackson commits the foul.
Wonder if it would
benefit. It's Ziegler going to the line.
Wonder if it would benefit Michigan to switch to a zone for a little bit here, and because they seem a little bit slower than Bowling Green trying to get there.
Franz Wagner has gone into the locker room, I believe. Ziegler's free throw, first one is good. 43-36. Now they're showing the replay on the Jumbotron of where Wagner rolled his ankle. Looks like his left ankle. Second free throw from Ziegler is out. Bowling Green misses a free throw there. 43-36, Wolverines on top. 35 seconds, there's about a 9-second difference between shot clock and game clock. Williams with it outside, tripped down. Ball is loose, Bowling Green will tie him up. And the possession arrow will give the ball to Bowling Green with 28 seconds remaining. They can hold it for the final shot, but possession arrow flips to Michigan, which means Wolverines will get it to start the second half.
Yeah, it's just a little bit of a freshman mistake there for Terrence Williams, trying to do a little too much.
Yeah, got tangled up there. Wolverines lead by 7, 20 seconds remaining. Falcons can hold for the final shot. And Justin Turner standing on the block M at center court. Now under 10 in the game clock. He's going to try and dribble around Brooks. Crossover, step back from 3. That shot off the mark. Brandon Johns the rebounds. 3 seconds, 2. Zeb Jackson comes up. 30-footer at the buzzer. And it's off the high glass and no good. Michigan will take a 7-point lead into halftime. They lead 43-36.
Definitely competitive first half. So we can definitely say that's pretty impressive. And Michigan getting was a little bit slow there at the end of the half, kind of on both sides, really mostly on the defense. I think Bowling Green was able to put some more pressure on Michigan on offense and be able to help help them kind of claw back into this as well.
And Michigan had built up to an 11-point lead at the 8:30 mark remaining of the first half. Bowling Green cut it all the way down to 3 at around the 4-minute timeout. But then Michigan able to build it back up to 7 as they head in to the halftime break. They put 15 minutes up for halftime, which I believe was standard for last year. Of course, last year you would have halftime entertainment with the fans. This year a little different, not much going on right now. Two folks with a mops going out to refurbish the court. It's an interesting setup we can convey to the listeners right now. They've got two tables for the scorer's table with huge plexiglass guarding the scorers from the players. And then the benches are a bunch of chairs that are set apart as opposed to just in a row. There's, I think, 3 rows of them where, and they go farther back into where the maze rage, the student section, would be. And then elsewhere, it's just pretty empty around the court with the courtside seats gone. And they've moved tarps back to have block ends around the court, and then a few cardboard cutouts in the first row where the maze rage would be.
Yeah, definitely a little quiet here at halftime.
Yeah,
for sure.
Especially compared to normal. But regardless, Michigan takes a 43-36 lead into halftime, 13:27 to go in this halftime. We will take about a 10-minute break, and we will be back to give you the second half in just a little bit. Welcome back now to the second half between Michigan and Bowling Green here at Crisler Center in Ann Arbor. Michigan with a 43-36 lead over the Falcons. About 2.5 minutes before tip-off for the second half. Players back out onto the floor warming up. Franz Wagner, I believe, is out there right now. Looks like they taped up part of his ankle.
Yeah, it sounds like his injury wasn't as serious as it initially looked. He might have just rolled his ankle a little bit there.
Michigan's players warming up in that first half. Wolverines shoot 48% from the floor, but only 31% from three, and defensively have some things to work on. Committed a lot of fouls in the first half. Bowling Green scores 36. Looking at the box score for Michigan, Livers with 13, Mike Smith with 12, nobody else above 5. And for Bowling Green, it was Plowden with 11 and Turner with 9. So some names standing out early for these two respective squads.
Yeah, I was very impressed with Michigan getting it, trying to get it on the boards, especially on defense there to grab the rebound. On offense as well, they're definitely crashing when someone takes a shot, especially later there in that second half.
Michigan wearing the home whites, Bowling Green wearing all orange uniforms. And they've got, it's like black-colored sweatshirts over their jerseys right now as they warm up. Michigan's got all white uniforms and white sweatshirts.
Very curious to see, though, in the second half, how Michigan is able to adjust a little bit. I think they're going to be a little bit more aggressive, or they're going to play a zone, or if they're going to continue to do what they do. I know they have a slight talent advantage right now, but definitely trying to keep on your toes is what I think Bowling Green is anticipating and doing the rest of this game.
Yeah, I'm interested to see how much of Hunter Dickinson we see in the second half. He had 4 points in that first half on 2 of 3 from the floor. He did attempt a three, was not able to make it. Played just 6 minutes in total. Looking at the center position, Johns played 7 minutes, Dickinson played 6, Davis played 6 to cover close to 20 minutes, but Johns wasn't always playing center, so some tinkering right now with the lineup, whereas Mike Smith played a hefty 16 minutes in that first half. Zeb Jackson got a couple minutes in at the end. Terrence Williams got 6 minutes in off the bench as well, so a few freshmen peeking through in the rotation, but none with major roles at the moment.
Yeah, John Jr. definitely got himself in a little bit of foul trouble there. That I don't think they used him as much in that first half. Of course, he's a bench player, so you don't expect him to see as much time as a starter, but definitely seeing more of him would be definitely a good sign for this team as well, because I think that definitely shows that Michigan's depth is more deep than I think that what they had last year.
Franz Wagner ready to inbound it in. Michigan has the possession arrow after that held ball in the final minute. Michigan won the opening tip. And they'll go with the same starting lineup to begin the second half. Wagner, Smith, Brooks, Davis, and Livers. Wagner dribbles around on the outside. Now he'll cut into the lane, kicks to Livers on the wing. His three-pointer rattles around and no good. Bowling Green gets the rebound. They come up the floor. Metheny holds it, staring down Smith. Now they go down low. Swingle back into the game. Backing in on Austin Davis. Davis playing good defense. He throws that one up. It's off the mark. Livers grabs down the rebound. Smith comes up the floor. He's going to dribble in the lane. Kicks it out to Livers. Wagner corner. His three-pointer rattles around. No good. Went down about halfway and popped out. Good-looking shot. But Michigan goes 0-for-2 to begin the second half from three. Now 4-of-15 for the game. Ice cold. Both teams at 27% from distance. Long step-back jumper from Plowden. No good. Davis grabs the rebound, but his pass is intercepted. Picked up in the lane. And then floated in there by Justin Turner. He's now up to 11, and it's 43-38.
Yeah, a little mistake there by Austin Davis. Just Kind of passed it without looking first.
Smith drives baseline, and he's going to get bumped as he dribbles down low. First foul of the second half called on Bowling Green. That'll be on Caden Matheny, who they say was his fourth on the PA. I think it's his third. That's what Stat Broadcast says. We'll have to check about that. Smith inbounds it to Brooks, flips it around to Wagner. He dribbles inside and got tapped from behind, lost the ball out of bounds, but another foul called and a reach in there. Two fouls back to back. That one goes on Caden Fields. Team second of the half. Now Michigan will inbound it right back in. Smith kicks to the corner. Isaiah Livers stepped out of bounds.
Oh, man.
That's a tough turnover there for Michigan. Second time today they've turned the ball over, stepping out of bounds. Eli Brooks did it earlier in the first half, and we see some of this rust right now with Michigan's team. 90 seconds into the second half, they hold a five-point lead. Justin Turner across to Plowden, gets the screen, dribbles into the lane, flips it up. Runner is short. Davis another board. Smith, Brooks, goes around a screen, inside, lays it up, no. Put back chance. They call a foul to begin with. Another foul on Bowling Green. Wow. That's going to be something to watch here. That'll be a shooting foul. So Eli Brooks should get two free throws.
Yeah, a little bit of lack of awareness for Michigan early on, a couple turnovers that could have been prevented.
Brooks steps to the free throw line, 73% last year. Foul goes on Swingle, and the first one by Brooks goes down, 44-38. Swingle's second, that one is through as well, 45-38. Passing around with it on the outside. Metheny comes up across half court. Now pass to Justin Turner. Gets a screen from Swingle. He goes inside. Tried to scoop it up. They say Austin Davis got his hand in there. Will stay with Bowling Green. 15 on the shot clock. 17:53 to go in the second half. 45-38 Wolverines.
Been impressive defense by Austin Davis so far I've seen this year in this first game.
Turner with the rock, switches on to Livers, now crosses it over, kicks across Metheny, wide open for three, his shot off the mark. It's a good look, but a little too strong. Rebound by Davis again. They come up the floor. Eli Brooks gets a small screen. His long two is good. 47-38, Michigan.
Nice screen set there, indeed.
Brooks got a little bit of separation, knocks down the long jumper. Metheny up the floor, cross to Turner. Gets a screen. I Brooks dribbles in the lane. That shot is short. Franz Wagner grabs down the rebound. Passes it up to Smith. Bounce pass. Livers drives inside. Lays it up and lays it in. Strong game from Livers so far. We're going to have a quick timeout by Bowling Green. Michigan on a 6-0 run. They lead 49-38, tying their largest lead of the game. Just about 3 minutes gone in the second half. You're listening to Michigan basketball on WCBN Sports. Michigan with this 11-point lead over the Bowling Green Falcons. Livers 15 points now, 6 of 11 from the floor, 3 of 6 from 3. Turner with 11 points, 5 of 12 from the field. Plowden 11 points, but 3 of 9 from the floor. Bowling Green as a whole shooting 33% from the field.
Yeah, Michigan continuing to try to hit those threes, but they're just not falling right now. I think later on in the game, maybe you can find some more open shots. They've been open. They just can't get them to fall right now, and it's been one of the issues that was last year as well, is getting some open threes, but just not being able to hit them.
This is a longer timeout from Bowling Green. Their second called by their coach, Michael Huger. Michigan, looks like Juwan Howard seated in the chair drawing up plays. But good to see Franz Wagner back out there for Michigan.
Yes.
Rolling his ankle late in the first half, had to go into the tunnel, but he comes out and starts the half for the Wolverines.
Yeah, expect to get hopefully later in the year, and I think Wagner is going to be more of an important factor for this team, especially going to be one of those like key pieces to the starting team that's going to make it so much easier for Michigan if he can get solid footing.
Yeah, preseason All Big Ten selection by the media who vote on that. Isaiah Livers also a guy that was in the conversation, but Wagner, someone that people expect to see him take a big jump in his sophomore season at Michigan. Austin Davis' line for the game, 2 points on a pair of free throws, but he's up to 5 rebounds. 2 turnovers, though, a bit of a problem. Eli Brooks, 4 points, hasn't attempted many shots, just 1 for 3 from the field. Mike Smith, if nothing else, has been very effective at drawing fouls, 12 points, and half of those coming on free throws.
Yeah, definitely for the size, I think it's important that he is able to draw a lot of fouls. That'll come a very important key later in games, I believe, and definitely when they're close. Isaiah Livers with 8 rebounds. Yeah, it's a pretty good, a really good effort by Isaiah Livers. You know, he's got all-around great player. He's very close, I think, to NBA ready. It's going to be interesting to see him in his future as well.
Yeah, and, you know, Livers is a guy that might have left for the NBA if he hadn't sustained injuries last year. Had some 2 or 3 different injuries recurring with the hamstrings. But he's back for his senior season at Michigan. The Wolverines very happy to have him back. Out of the timeout, Metheny with the ball. Passes it across, gets it right back. Long three-pointer there, rims around and out. Ball loose on the floor. Livers dives for it, can't collect it. Now Plowden's got it in the corner, 17 on the shot clock. Guarded by Wagner, kicks it out. Turner open from three, and that one is swished right through. Justin Turner now 14 points. And that cuts it back to 8.
Bowling Green very agile on the boards. I mean, they are very, very aggressive trying to get the ball.
Smith dribbles around, kicks it out to Eli Brooks. Brooks inside, lays it up and lays it in. Right hand off the glass, and the lead's back to double digits. Michigan quickly attacking there on their offensive possession. Almost 4 minutes gone now in the second half. Metheny gets another small screen. Bowling Green very ball screen heavy offense. Play up tempo, but not crazy. Now dribbling inside, kick to Swengel. Baseline, little jumper, oh, and an offensive rebound put back.
Wow.
Jam by Daquan Plowden. Franz Wagner was standing there just looking at the basketball as it was rimming around. Plowden guessed it was going to pop off, and he just came flying out of nowhere and jackhammer slam to put it back in. 51-43, Smith goes right around the center, Swengel, and lays it in with the right hand. 53-43, Michigan's made 4 straight from the floor. They still lead by 10. Metheny, guarded by Smith, turns around, kicks it out to Plowden with 13 points. His three-pointer there off the mark. Davis can't corral that rebound. It was a big arcing one that went just over his long outstretched limbs. Now here's an off-balance shot. That one tipped around. We're going to get a foul on Swengel, I believe, underneath. Yep, and that's going to be his 4th foul, so he'll head to the bench. And now we have the under 16 media timeout. Michigan will take the ball back over, leading by 10, 53-43. Now they've seized the crowd noise that's being piped into this arena. Very, very quiet right now as they're doing the customary the team, the team, the team graphic on the Jumbotron.
Yeah, right there for Michigan, I think. A lot of the shots for Bowling Green, if they've been off the rim, they've been like arcing rebounds. So it's been tough for Michigan to try to judge where those are going to go a lot. And right now, Michigan trying to give all they can get from the rebound right now, but Bowling Green's able to be just a little bit more quicker on the offensive board.
And you have to like overall what Michigan's doing in this game because, you know, they lead by 10, but they're at 27% from three. If you just bump that up to, say, 35% around where they were last year, you know, that's almost about a 15 or 16 point game, which is what you might expect. So Michigan's doing everything, not quite getting the 3-point luck at the moment, but they've got a solid lead at the moment and forcing tough shots from Bowling Green. And that's part of the reason that these rebounds have been so big is that the shots are off balance. They're not really close and they're taking big jumps. Bowling Green though does have 8 offensive rebounds as a whole, Michigan with 4. Points off turnovers pretty even, 9-8, and turnovers as a whole, 7-5, Michigan. Both teams shooting strikingly even at three-pointers and free throws. Both teams at 27% from three, and both teams at just over 80% from the free throw line.
Yeah, I think early on, you know, it's going to be not the greatest shooting, I think, early on. You know, it's just been a pretty close game, is as close as you would expect this game to be against two very competitive teams. As the year goes on, it's going to be more of a telling sign of how Michigan is able to adjust, especially from beyond the arc. And Bowling Green, I think this is how they're going to try to compete in the MAC and maybe even win the MAC outright as well, because they are a very solid team. And honestly, they can cause a lot of problems for even teams outside their conference.
Yeah, they definitely played a solid game here today. And this is really their only game against a major conference opponent. In the non-conference, they play App State and South Carolina State and Wright State. Those are their three other non-conference. And then the rest are MAC games. So this was really their only chance to test their team against a high major opponent. Michigan entered this game ranked 25th in the AP preseason poll, so a good test regardless. In Bowling Green, Ohio, not far from Ann Arbor, just over an hour drive south of Toledo. Just a quick trek north and a good test for their squad. Out of the timeout, Mike Smith with the ball. Michigan leads it by 10. If they can score on this possession, they'll get their largest lead of the game. Smith dribbles around, kicks to Brooks in the corner, back to Smith, in to Davis. 10 on the shot clock, backs inside, lays it up, off the mark, no, tipped around, offensive rebound goes out of bounds, off Bowling Green. Michigan will retain possession. Davis had a good look there, and he shot almost 70% from the floor in those layup and dunk situations last year. Couldn't quite get that one to fall, but that's a look you like. Good inbound pass from Brooks to Wagner in the corner. Back to Wagner, back to Mike Smith. Bowling Green playing a little bit of a zone defense right now. Brooks across, Wagner outside. His three-pointer is just a little off the mark. Wagner 0 for 4 from distance today. Shaundy Brown runs out to the scorer's table. He'll be ready to come in at the next break. Bowling Green passes it around the outside. Dribbling into the lane, Turner. Step back, jumper at the free throw line, off the mark. Austin Davis corrals the rebound. That's another one for the big man. Count it 6 for number 51. They get it right to him at the free throw line. Nice pass inside. Mike Smith's layup is no good. A great chance there, and just couldn't quite finish. Great pass from Davis, though. Here comes Metheny inside, lays it up, and a foul is drawn on a bit of an acrobatic dive there from Metheny on the baseline. They'll hit Wagner with the foul. That's his first.
That was a little generous foul right there.
Yeah. But as we noted in the first half, Michigan got a few nice calls underneath there as well. So evening out in the end.
Yes.
Metheny at the free throw line. His first free throw is good.
Michigan from the three-point line just seems a little rushed right now, I think, from the three. I think that's why they're missing some as well.
Yeah, 4 of 16 now from beyond the arc for Michigan. Hunter Dickinson checks in. Austin Davis hits the bench. Dickinson tucking in his jersey as he stands and watches the second free throw go down. 8-point lead for Michigan. Now here comes aggressive defense from Bowling Green, again playing a bit of a zone at the moment. They tended to be a man defense overall, but trying to switch something up. Great pass, Smith, now Livers. Great pass again. Shaundy Brown for three, and he knocks it through. Michigan leads by 11. Third time today they've led by 11, have never gotten beyond that. But a 56-45 advantage, 13:25 to go. Isaiah Washington with the ball. Now they pass it around. Turner at the elbow, switches on to Dickinson. Pass back inside to Washington. Great feed from Justin Turner there. He's got 14 points. That's his first assist of the game. Michigan comes up in transition. Wagner, quick pass. Dickinson misses the easy lay-in there, but Brown gets the rebound. He'll kick it. Smith for three from the wing. That one, no. Shaundy Brown, the offensive board for the putback. Michigan playing with a lot of energy on the offensive side of the ball right now. 7 minutes gone in the first half. They lead by 11. Metheny gets the screen. Passes it across. Now they get it over. Back to Metheny. 10 on the shot clock. He switched on to Wagner, so he's going to have a height disadvantage, but perhaps a quickness advantage. Metheny's long, long three. It's way too strong. Big rebound. Grabbed down by Shaundy Brown. Up to Mike Smith. Smith goes around Metheny, and he'll draw a bump on the Bowling Green point guard.
Crazy pass out to Franz Wagner. He was able to make that three, too. So it's been kind of a rough day from behind the arc for Michigan, and they do get a foul, and that's been the story of the game for Bowling Green, is getting some foul calls early on.
That's a fourth foul on Metheny, so he'll hit the bench. Michigan inbounds it in. Here comes Smith dribbling in the lane, kicks outside. Shaundy Brown for three. That one is good. And the transfer from Wake Forest knocks back-to-back triples in. Michigan now leads by 14, and Brown is fired up. So is Juwan Howard. He was looking right at Brown after he put that one through. Now the bench is standing, and Howard encouraging them to get vocal. Bowling Green now at a tipping point moment in this basketball game. Plowden with it outside, goes around Livers, dribbles inside. Help defense comes from Dickinson, and Plowden will draw the foul on the freshman big man for Michigan. We hit the under 12 media timeout. 61-47, Michigan on top. 11:46 to go in the first half. You're listening to Michigan Basketball on WCBN Sports. Well, we've seen in these last couple possessions the passing ability of Mike Smith, and he's a better shooter than Xavier Simpson, but you can see some elements of Simpson's game in the way he's been able to slash in the lane and then really distribute the ball well around the perimeter.
Yeah, he's very crafty when it comes to passing the ball around, and he even has, I think, a better touch on his three-point game than I think Simpson had when he was here.
Yeah.
So that will be, a big advantage for them going forward as well. It's something that I think in key moments last year that Simpson couldn't be able to quite nail later in games, was try to be that man that maybe they could hit a big three-pointer later in a game. So Mike Smith has that ability, and I think going forward it's going to be something to watch.
Well, Mike Smith's a guy that played a ton of minutes at Columbia last year on a team that really struggled. He was asked to do way more than you should ask any player to do. Averaged 23 points a game, but here in this offense, he'll be able to really distribute to his teammates more. Last year, his teammates were not reliable scorers, but this year, with guys like Livers and Wagner, you can kick the ball out to, is, you know, going to give him a lot of options, and hopefully you can see some effectiveness in ball distribution.
Yeah, absolutely. And Wagner hasn't played as much as he would like today, or played as well as he would like so far. But, you know, I think as we go forward, it's going to be one of those things where he's going to be able to develop a lot, I think, pretty quickly, especially early in the season, against some of these opponents. But I think right now the best opportunity, if you want to hit a three right now, is continuing feeding Brown right now. He's had two in a row go down right now, and I think it's one of the only players that Michigan has had well, him and Livers right now on multiple three-pointers made. And I think being able to keep that fire under their belt right now is going to be important.
11:46 to go here in the second half. Michigan 61, Bowling Green 47. Both teams at their huddles, drawing up plays and discussing how they want to go about things.
It is shocking this year with the cardboard cutouts that we only have one line of cardboard cutouts right now.
Yeah, you'd think there'd be more with a lot of an empty arena right now, but just lining that side of where the Maze Rage would be. And not very many, only about three sections of them. One row and three sections, maybe about 30 in total.
Maybe everyone got theirs in late and they're still waiting on theirs.
Yeah. Out of the timeout, it'll be Smith, Wagner, Brown, Dickinson, and Johns for Michigan. And Daquan Plowden at the free throw line. First free throw is good. He's a very good free throw shooter. He's now 4-for-4 on the game. His second one upcoming. A very odd free throw motion. Kind of dribbles it to the side. And his second one is good. Now up to 5-for-5 on the day. 61-49, Michigan on top. Smith with the ball, flips it to Dickinson. Johns inside Wagner, easy lay-in right there. Got free over the defenders and a good pass from Brandon Johns.
Nice setup right there. That was beautifully executed on offense.
Johns has made a couple nice passes so far today. Now Trey Diggs gives it to Justin Turner. He drives to the rack, lays it up. Oh, just off the mark. Michigan tips it out of bounds, though. Ball will stay with Bowling Green. Turner's explosiveness definitely seems better than normal for a MAC caliber player. Brooks checks in. Smith will hit the bench. They inbound it in. Oh, Johns! Is he able to save it? No. He got a hand on it, and there's what you mentioned. Players really being aggressive there with not many fans on the sideline. He ran way off the court. Now, Plowden will have to do the inbound out near half court where Johns went out of bounds as opposed to under the basket.
Yeah, it's definitely going to be key, I think, for Michigan if they can get some help, especially if a man gets loose on a screen.
Plowden over to Ziegler. They get Trey Diggs running free. He's open for three. Johns with a hand up, but Diggs knocks it through. Good three-pointer there for Bowling Green and cuts the lead back to 11, and now they're going to take a break. I mean, maybe a substitution or something going on. No one's coming on the floor, but the referees... Warning issued to Cade Young, not sure for what. Eli Brooks dribbles the ball up, gets a screen from Dickinson. Tight defense on him, passes it to Shaundy Brown. Now double team comes, flips it out to Brooks. Now inside, what a pass to Brandon Johns. But I think a foul was committed underneath first by Bowling Green.
One
more. It was going to be an easy lay-in.
Yeah, one more and they're in the bonus.
Yeah. Six fouls now on Bowling Green, two on Michigan. 10:41 to go in the second half, 11-point game. Brown inbounds to Brooks. They get Wagner running free. Now he dribbles inside, lays it up, count it, and a foul. Rattled around the rim there for a moment and then goes down.
Yeah, that's something I think, that was a bucket that I think needed to go home for Franz Wagner to get a little bit of energy in him.
Yeah. He's now 4 of 6 on twos, and then the glaring 0 for 4 from 3, but Wagner now 9 points. He'll get his one extra free throw here. And that one's off the mark. Wagner now 1 for 3 from the free throw line, uncharacteristic for a very good free throw shooter. Michigan's lead stays at 13, 65-52. Plowden with the ball, guarded by Dickinson. Outside, dribbling inside Ziegler, and he'll get bumped underneath.
Michigan foul is number 23, Brandon
And that'll be on Brandon Johns, his third personal. Shooting foul. Two free throws upcoming for Diggs. Or sorry, for Ziegler. Ziegler's first is off the heel. It's just the third free throw missed today for Bowling Green. They're 13 for 16 now. Second one on the way. That one's short as well. Two misses there from Ziegler.
And wow.
The teams collectively have missed three in a row now. Eli Brooks with the rock. Gets a small screen from Johns. Now another one comes from Dickinson. Doesn't do much with it. Now gets it to Dickinson. Another foul on Bowling Green. Wow. I think they were trying to harass Dickinson from behind, and he should shoot a one and one now. Well, this will now be Hunter Dickinson's first collegiate free throw, and it's off the mark. Four straight free throws missed by the two teams collectively. We're at the halfway point exactly of the second half. Michigan holds a 13-point edge, 65-52. They've held that big edge for most of the second half, but haven't quite gotten it into blowout territory. Dribbling inside, look at that, up and under by Justin Turner.
Wow.
Beautiful acrobatic layup there to go evade the arms of Hunter Dickinson. Now Brown with the ball in the wing. His three-pointer from the corner, Shondi Brown. Now 3 of 4 from distance today. Michigan leads by 14, their largest lead of the game. Shondi Brown providing energy off the bench. Here comes Turner again, swatted by Dickinson, but they call a foul. I don't know about that one.
Yeah, that was close.
Yeah, really vigorous block attempt there from Dickinson. That'll be his third foul. We can take a look at the replay in a moment. They're showing us the Shondi Brown three-pointer. But it'll be Justin Turner going to the line. He got around Shondi Brown, and Dickinson came over on the help side. Swatted the ball, but got a little hand, they say. And Turner swishes the first free throw. He's up to 17 points. Turner was averaging 19 a game last season. He's an 85% free throw shooter, now 2 for 2 on the day. And it breaks the streak of these teams missing free throws at 4. His second free throw on the way, and he rattles that one home as well. 68-56, 9:22 to go. Michigan now up to 35% from 3 with this spurt from Shondi Brown.
He's really looked like he's into form right now, I think.
Yeah. Dickinson with the ball. Nice bounce pass to Johns, but hand got in the way. Bowling Green takes it away up the floor quickly, and they missed the jam. Don't know what number that was that missed the dunk. The offensive rebound snagged in the corner by Justin Turner. He'll call a timeout as Michigan had him cornered. Bowling Green now has just one timeout remaining. Wow, that was a quick turn of events. The turnover for Michigan. Let's see who that was. And so that was Plowden who missed the jam. Dickinson came over to contest it, didn't get any of it, and Plowden just missed the two-handed slam.
Yeah, Hunter Dickinson, he looks a little antsy out there. He's not very confident in himself, it looks like. He's afraid that he's going to get called for another foul, because I think a couple of fouls went against him early in the game, that he's has a little happy feet not being able to be able to make the right move at the right time. But that can be definitely adjusted, and he'll learn from that as he moves forward.
Only a 30-second timeout for Bowling Green. They'll have 18 on the shot clock. Struggling to inbound it. Now they finally get it into an open Turner for three, and it's
wow.
Through. Turner knocks down the long ball there, and he's now at 21 points. The lead back down to 9, a quick 5-0 spurt for Bowling Green. Brandon Johns with the ball over to Brooks. Long two there for Eli Brooks off the mark. Dickinson the rebound, put back, no. And close range from Dickinson on the offensive board. Can't get it. Michigan had made their last five field goals before those pair of misses. Dribbling inside, Turner flips it up, no. Dickinson rebound. And four or five bodies laying at his feet. He had to wait for the path to clear. Now gives it to Brooks, who brings it up the court. Brooks swings. Shaundi Brown open. Can he do it again? Yes, he can. Shaundi Brown knocks through another three-pointer. He's 4 of 5 here on the game. 12-point Michigan lead, 8 minutes to go.
Wow, that's impressive. 4 for 4 for him from three.
Now on the low post, Turner guarded by that man Brown. Switches on to Johns. Fadeaway jumper, no, and Brown grabs the rebound. Nice leap there to pick it up. Now he sees some space, dribbles inside, and draws a foul from behind before the shot. Be a foul on the floor. It'll be a 1-1 after the media timeout here. Under 8 minutes remaining in the game. 7:38 to go, 71-59. Michigan on top. You're listening to Michigan basketball on WCBN Sports. I want to thank all of you for joining us here again today. Michigan basketball getting underway in what will be an eventful weekend here in Ann Arbor, and we'll have a lot of games coming up this weekend. Michigan basketball today, nothing tomorrow with Thanksgiving, and then hockey Friday, Saturday, as well as women's basketball on Friday. Michigan men will be back at it on Sunday, and then football at the Big House on Saturday. A lot of action going on. Michigan leads by 12 here in this game, 7:38 to go. Looking at the split box, now Livers 15, Brown 15, Smith 14. They've powered a good chunk of the Michigan offense, as has Wagner with 9. As for Bowling Green, it's two-man story. Turner with 21 and Plowden with 15. Turner's taken 20 shots out of the 55 total that Bowling Green's taken as a team. Usage very high in this game.
Yeah, definitely. I think Michigan, I think this is what we expected from this team, is being very distributive and not really having one guy really stand out above the other, which I think is much more important than always having to rely on one man. Because I think going forward, that's going to be more difficult when you face the tougher teams. It's also being able to know that you can count on more than one man out there. Low. And the free throw percentage for both teams a little lower than they wanted today, but it's not too bad to start the year.
Yeah, both in the 70% range there. But Shaundi Brown's shooting the story of the second half at the moment. 5 for 6 from the floor, 4 of 5 from three. Livers 3 of 6 from three. The rest of the team pretty ice cold. Michigan's made 8 threes as a team and 7 from those two players. The remainder of the team is just 1 for 10.
Yeah, we'll see here in the final minutes if some of those players can heat up, but just a little bit, you know, to grab some, put some confidence in them going forward.
Michigan trying to close out this game and get the win in their opening game of the season. Shaundi Brown stands at the free throw line. He's 1 for 2 today. This is a 1-1, so the first free throw is important, and he makes it. 72-59. He'll get a second shot. Now up to 2 for 3 on the day from the free throw line. Bends the knees, only one dribble. His second try rims around and out, so 2 for 4 from the day. Was a better shooter than that at the free throw line last year at Wake Forest, but he restores the Michigan lead up to 13. Really good defense at the moment being played by him as they pass it around. Now long three off the mark. Brooks skies up for the rebound after that miss from Chandler Turner. Brooks with the ball. Passes it across to Livers. Back to Brooks. Open for three. Pump fake. Now back to Brown from the wing for three. That one looked off the mark all the way, and it was Dickinson, the rebound. Oh, nice. Count it. And a foul.
Nice positioning by Hunter Dickinson. That was, I think, much needed by him. He was being a little hesitant up until then, and he just used his body there to be able to get a nice little put back there.
Yeah, Dickinson uses the height advantage underneath that he has to snag that rebound, put it up, and put it in. Now he gets a free throw. He's 0 for 1 on the day from the free throw line. Michigan now on a 6-0 run in the last minute. They've got their largest lead of the game at 15, and Dickinson can make it 16 here. And his free throw is good. 75-59, Michigan on top, starting to pull away here with 7 minutes to play. 10 fouls now on Bowling Green. Michigan in the double bonus. Trey Diggs with it outside. Long three from him, and it's good. Wow. That was close to 30 feet away. And with good defense played there by Eli Brooks. Now Michigan comes up the floor quickly. Screen set from Dickinson. Now over to Brown. Inside, Dickinson got that height advantage as well. Backing in. Lays it up with the left hand. And it's good.
I think he's found his rhythm right now.
Yeah, Dickinson playing well. He's now got 9 points for Michigan in his freshman debut. Matheny back out onto the court. Hands it off to Turner. Fadeaway jumper. That one, no. Plowden grabs the rebound, kicks it out to Matheny. Now back around Turner. Trying to dribble in the lane. Throws on the brakes. Kicks it out. Open shot from the wing. No. Ball tipped around. Dickinson grabs down the rebound. Flips it up to Brown. 6 minutes to play. Shaundy Brown inside. Kicks corner. Eli Brooks for three, and it's good. Michigan now leads by 18, and they're pouring it on here in the later stages of the second half.
Yeah, they definitely seem to be heating up a little bit more right now. I think they finally found something.
Justin Turner comes up the floor as this game's starting to slip away from Bowling Green. Trey Diggs, another long three, and another long make. Wow.
You just got to give hats off to him. Wow, well, those are two impressive shots.
Sensing the urgency in this game for his team, and he's just jacking them up, and they're falling through right now for the Falcons. Smith out onto the floor now. He dribbles inside. Corner, Livers, his three. No, Dickinson the rebound. Double team, and I think they fouled him underneath.
I think if you, Dickinson, you probably think about probably just putting that right back up. I think he definitely had the height advantage to just be able to put that up back on the board.
Yeah, Justin Turner fouled him underneath, so now Dickinson will go to the line in the double bonus. He'll get two free throws. Dickinson 1 for 2 today from the free throw line. He made his last attempt, trying to get into double figures here in his first game at Michigan. Big freshman from Alexandria, Virginia, bends the knees. The first free throw is a swish, 81-65. Jacob Washington checks in for Bowling Green. Dickinson gets his second, two dribbles, and he puts that one through. Two makes at the line, 3 for 4 on the day for the big man at the free throw line. 17-point lead. He's got 11 now on the day. 82-65, Michigan on top. Almost 5 minutes exactly to play here. Smith lost his defensive assignment. Trey Diggs for three again. Trey Diggs makes it from three again. Three straight makes from distance for Diggs, and he cuts the lead to 14. He's the only reason Bowling Green is anywhere close at the moment. Good kick. Smith to Brown. From the corner, Shaundy Brown again.
It's raining threes out here.
Yeah. That's his fifth make from distance. Shaundy Brown, 19 points on the game. He's 5 for 7 from behind the arc. And Mike Smith, another great assist. He's got 6 of those on the day. And there's a steal. Livers takes it away. Smith flips it up. Livers, the jam!
Oh, wow.
Isaiah Livers, that's the 7th assist from Smith in the most triumphant, the underhand scoop lob and the two-handed slam from Isaiah Livers, the senior from Kalamazoo, Michigan. Diggs for three again. Diggs makes it for three again. Holy mackerel.
Just incredible.
Four straight three-pointers from Trey Diggs, but Michigan still leads it by 16. Bowling Green's made their last three from the field, and those are all just three-pointers heaved by Trey Diggs. And now a push-off from Mike Smith will send us to the under four timeout, an offensive foul, his third personal, and we head to the final commercial timeout. Our score, Michigan 87, Bowling Green 71. You're listening to Michigan Basketball on WCBN Sports. This has definitely been an exciting last about 4 minutes or so of basketball. Bowling Green now for the game is up to 42% on threes, but that's pretty much all the doing of Trey Diggs. Started 0 for 2 from 3. He's now up to 4 for 6 from 3 after four straight makes, and a couple of those from way downtown.
Yeah, and you could say the same for Michigan is really five by Brown there from beyond the arc is really, it's what kind of helped heat up Michigan, I think, really to start it all. But Trey Diggs, man, it's just impressive. I mean, well, he was taking some almost NBA-like threes right there. And that was just, they looked like they heaped him up, but they made him look so easy at the same time.
'87-71, Michigan on top. Three main scorers for Bowling Green. Turner 24, Plowden 15, and Diggs 12. Michigan's got four in double figures and two players with nine. Brooks and Wagner waiting to crack double digits. Dickinson 11, Smith 14, Livers 17, and Brown 19. Austin Davis has six rebounds, Wagner with six, Dickinson with seven, and Livers with eight. Mike Smith with seven assists to lead the Wolverines. Bowling Green's got three players with four fouls. Matheny, Cam Young, and Swingle, the center.
Yeah, and what started off to be a kind of a slow, kind of decent game turned out to be a shooting fest here in the last 5 minutes of this second half.
Yeah.
It's amazing how, I think, physical these teams have been playing, that they only combined for 15 turnovers today, which is, no, I would say pretty low considering how they play.
Out of the timeout, 3:52 to go in the game. 87-71, Michigan on top, trying to close out this season opening victory. Michigan's made five of their last six from the field. Bowling Green, three of their last three. All three-pointers from Diggs. The Falcons have the ball. They inbound it into Justin Turner. Turner dribbles up the court, gets a screen. Diggs back to Turner. Guarded by Smith. Turner in the lane, swatted by Dickinson. He grabs the rebound. Brooks comes up with it. He's going to dribble in the lane, dish to Shaundy Brown. Awkward pass, and then I think that was a pass attempt that hit the rim. Bowling Green grabs it down. Turner up the floor. His three-pointer is no good. Smith grabs the rebound, flips it to Eli Brooks in transition. Brooks inside, lays it up with the left hand, and good. 89-71, Michigan.
A lot of back and forth there. I bet there's some tired feet there.
Yeah, this has definitely been a fast-paced second half, running up and down the floor. Kick to Matheny in the corner, guarded by Smith. Now over to Diggs, another three-point attempt, and that one is his first miss in a while. Just left it a little short. Sean D. Brown playing good defense. Got a hand up to contest. Smith corrals the rebound. 2:40 to go in the game. Michigan leads by 18. Smith is left open. Now swings. Livers open for three from the wing. That one just a little off the mark. Livers today now 3 of 8 from distance. Wagner's been sitting on the bench for a while now. Matheny kicks to Diggs. Here's another three-point attempt, and he makes that one. Diggs now with his fifth make from distance cuts the lead back to 15. He's 5 of 8 from three on the game. All five of his field goals are three-pointers.
He's making a really great moves.
Smith inside, and he's going to draw a foul on the floor beforehand. And with Michigan in the double bonus, he'll get two free throws. Caden Matheny, that's his fifth foul. He has fouled out of this game. Plowden will check in. They're going to have to bring another player in off the bench. That looks like number 12, Isaac Elsasser. Elsasser in the game for the first time today with a shooting sleeve on. Smith at the line. He is 5 for 6 today from the stripe. He makes the first. Looking for high fives. Has to retreat to find them from his teammates. Brandon Johns is going to check back into the game for Dickinson. Juwan Howard, a quick slap on the rear as Dickinson heads to the end of the bench. A fine debut for him, 11 points. Smith's second rattles around and down. He's now 7 for 8 from the line today. Michigan leads by 17, 91-74, 2 minutes remaining. They get it back to Diggs, his three-pointer again, and he makes another one! Diggs, 6 for 9 from three.
You just gotta give props to him. It's just, he's being contested on all those shots. He's just making them.
Smith to Sean D. Brown to Johns. Johns backing in, and he'll put it up and one. A little right-handed hook there goes down, and Michigan leads 93-77. Johns will go to the free throw line. Diggs is the one committing the foul. And John swishes that, 94-77. Guarded by Turner. Bowling Green passes it around outside, and Diggs draws a shooting foul from three. Ooh. He didn't make that one, but he draws a foul.
So hard to stop him. Just felt such a big rhythm right now, just not letting up.
Diggs goes to the line. He'll be shooting three. Diggs made 79% from the line last season. He makes the first. Diggs now has got 19 points with that first free throw. 94-78 the score. His second one is good.
And he makes that free throw look so effortless as well.
Now Terrence Williams checks into the game, as does Zeb Jackson. Michigan going to roll with Smith, Brown, Johns, Williams, and Jackson. Diggs makes the third one. He now has got 21 points, and I think all of his points are in the second half and in the last, like, 8 minutes or so. Jackson gets a quick screen from Terrence Williams. Williams dribbles inside, tries to put up a shot. It rims around, and it goes down. He's now got 4 points. Michigan leads by 16, under a minute remaining. Michigan's made 5 of their last 6 from the floor. Dribbling inside, laying it up, and no good there. Michigan the rebound, Williams to Smith. 45 seconds remaining, and they're closing it down right now. Smith with the ball. Gets a screen from Johns. Kicks it out. Williams for three. Williams shot off the mark. Tipped around. Johns can't corral the rebound. Shot clock off. 25 seconds left in the game. Bowling Green to Diggs. His three-pointer off the mark. Can't quite cap off the magical day. Rebound tipped around. Bowling Green gets it back. Nice pass underneath by Washington. Find an open man, Caleb Fields, who lays it in, and Michigan's going to win this one by 14. The final score will be 96-82 as the final seconds expire. And that does it. Juwan Howard just waves to the coaching staff and an elbow bump with the Bowling Green team. And they'll head into their respective locker rooms. That does it. 96-82. Michigan wins by 14, and they win both halves by 7. 43-36 in the first half and 53-46 in the second half. Michigan moves to 1-0 on the season.
Yeah, that was definitely, it felt like more like an NBA game with all that shooting there at the end. And just confidence. And I think just skill out, just was able to take shape right here. I think that was exactly the line for this game was 13.5. So I think they hit right that number.
And Michigan wins this one. An impressive display of offense from the Wolverines. They shoot 54% from the floor. They get to the line 26 times, make 77% of those. Shaundi Brown leads Michigan with 19, Livers 17, Smith 16, Dickinson 11, and Brooks 11 for Bowling Green, 24 for Justin Turner, 21 for Diggs, and 15 for Plowden. So Michigan wins this one by 14. Any last thoughts?
Yeah, I was definitely a lot more impressed with Michigan there in the second half with their offense. Their defense is okay. I mean, it's going to have to get a little bit better, but it's been getting there so far, and I think as the season moves on, we're going to be able to see it improve.
Yeah, Michigan facing a Bowling Green team that was pretty solid last year offensively, and they withstood a barrage of threes in the second half, all from Trey Diggs, who finishes 6 for 10 from beyond the
impressive
arc. That's it for the final score. Michigan 96, Bowling Green 82. For Ryan Buckman, I'm Alex Drain. Signing off from Crisler Center, and we'll leave you with a happy Thanksgiving. Good night, and go Blue.